Hi and welcome. This is Jam Jar 34 for another Herbrack episode where I will be doing the skin on this female Chaos model. So far, what I've done, just to speed it up a little bit, is Bugsman Glow. And some Rykon flesh shade on, as you can see, not on the face or on that leg, but on the waistline and the right leg. So it's all hunky dory. I will also be using Mephiston Red and Caro Berg Crimson for the little scarfing on the left leg. So what I'm going to start off with is I'm going to put my Canadian flesh tone, which I will show you on the model. Not going to right to the edge. And then this side. I'll carry it on. Like so, excuse me. Make a fine point in my white palette. Turn it around for ease. Hands are a little bit shaky, unfortunately. I'll just take that away. Move a couple of pots in the way, so I can get better look at it. Sorry for the camera angle. And then I will carry on going over the leg. So you have colour like that, so it's a little bit more thinner. I'll do the waistline. There you go. There's another little thing which I'll do, which I'm going to do. If I plonk that down there for the time being, I'm going to get some fist on red. Yeah, you need a little bit. Don't need a lot. And I might do this off camera just to show you what I'm doing. And all I'm basically doing is just picking out the higher raised bits. If it focuses, there, and a little bit there. So I'll pick those bits out. Grab the red wash. And quite a lot of it, because it doesn't matter if it goes anywhere else. And while it's dryish, pinpoint marks. Dry off with the brush. Bits. Then we have the regular flesh shade, which I'll be using. Viking flesh shade, sorry. I'm going to just go over the whole of that, including the red, so it all sort of merges in as one. Then obviously underneath here. bit more for the neck, a bit more for the face as well. Which I'm going to dry off. Then the last stage that you want to do is this one. With the variants of colours, you can also do skin tones of various amounts. So different skin tones, different hair, and also for males as well. So that's an example of another skin tone that I'm doing, but this is the preferred one for this particular female chaos person. And I'm just going to do the final so you have it here. I'm just going to quickly do it. Off camera, just for you to look at the after result. So I've painted just above the last colour, and then I've just touched up a few bits here and there. Now I'll put another coat on to see if I can make it quite smooth, as smooth as I possibly can. Quite thin tone, it shows the muscle to be under. The kneecap and obviously the little wounds there, which around it you can put a darker colour and a lighter colour, exactly using the same thing. And that's how I do female skin, but I also do it in a load of other ways, using darkish greys to do snish females as well. And yeah, I hope you like this one. It's not the best, it's just how I do it. Doesn't look too bad. So guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked this little tutorial. Something different. Any questions? I've got the kneecap there, obviously. Got it really light. And as you can see, it should be two shades of colour, roughly there. And obviously the little wounds as well. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching. Do all the funky stuff down below. Like, subscribe, share. And I'll see you in the next Herb Rack. Bye for now. Bye bye.